Hello and welcome to this video. Today we're going to look at how to parent props to a rig in Blender using Rig-GNS. Alright, so this blend file was sent to me by a user who was having difficulties parenting certain items in this scene to the rig. And today we're going to address this issue and find a solution. Since this figure was exported from DAS using the deformorphic method, our first step will be to ensure compatibility with Rig-GNS. And now to do this, I'll simply click the Convert to GNS button and then click OK. Something I immediately noticed after converting the armature is that the beard and the mustache seem to have disappeared. So now let's undo the conversion by pressing Ctrl Z. And now you can see the beard and the mustache are back. It appears these objects have some physics properties, and we can confirm this by checking the modifiers panel. And as suspected, it has a shrink wrap modifier and a particle system modifier. Now, so for this reason, I'm going to separate the beard from the rig by pressing Alt P and then select Clear and Keep Transformation. I'll do the same for the mustache here, Alt P, Clear and Keep Transformation. Now, with that done, I'm going to select the primary armature here in the outliner and then click on the Convert to GNS button and then OK. Now, with the rig converted, I'm going to proceed with the rigging button here. I'm going to click Add Meta Rig, then Match Rig, then Generate Rig. And when that is done, I'll go ahead and click the Rig Figure button. Okay, now we have the figure fully rigged. So the next step is to check if these objects, which are part of the head, move along with it. So I'm going to select this head bone and then press the R key twice to rotate it. And as you can see, none of these items are following the head. The hair is not following the head, neither are the eyebrows, the glasses, the mustache or the beard. You can see how the shrink wrap modifier on the beard and the mustache causes them to wrap around the face of the figure as I rotate the head around. Alright, let's now look at the button for parenting this object to the rig, which is found here in the Animixa setup. But before demonstrating how to use this button, we need to switch to object mode and then select the unparented item. Now let's start with the hair. I'll select it and then click parent prop to rig. Now clicking the button pops up a menu with four parenting options, which are bone, vertex, auto, and transfer. The bone option parents the selected objects to a single bone in the armature, but I don't usually use this option for objects that are part of the figure. However, for this hair, I'm going to select the vertex option. So as soon as I select this vertex option, a parent bone option appears on the menu. And this option provides the closest bone to the item, which in this case is the head bone. And if for any reason you prefer to work with a different bone, you can click on this field to get a drop-down list of bones to which you can parent to the mesh. But in this case, we're going to go with the head bone and then click OK. Alright, now the hair is parented to the rig. We can verify this by selecting the rig, switching to pose mode, and then pressing the R key twice to rotate the head bone. And now you can see the hair is moving along with the head. I should point out that the vertex option created a vertex group that enables the head bone to influence the hair. And to see this, I will go to weight paint mode, select the sample vertex group tool here, click a region on the hair to see the vertex groups. You can see we have just this vertex group called head, and its bone heat is represented by the red color all over the hair. The assigned vertex group can also be found here in the vertex group tab of the properties panel, which is this head here. Now let's work on the eyebrow. You can see both the left brow and the right brow are one object. So I'll go ahead and click the prop to rig button. This time I'm not going to use the vertex option since it only assigns one vertex group to the entire object as we saw with the hair. But the eyebrows here are supposed to be influenced by several vertex groups around the brow region of the figure. Let me show you this by selecting the figure and going to its paint mode. I still have the sample vertex group tool selected. Now clicking on the region around the brows, you can see we have all these different vertex groups. Let's sample the brow inner group, and immediately we can see the bone heat representing the weight of the vertex group. Now let's sample a different area. And remember, we can also view the bone heat for this different vertex group by selecting any of this group on the vertex group tab of the properties panel. So the transfer option takes those bone heats for those vertex groups from the figure and transfers them to the corresponding part on the eyebrow. Okay, so now I will return to object mode, select the brows, click parent prop to rig, and then select transfer, and then click OK. And this usually takes a few seconds, so let's wait for that to finish. Okay, that is done. Now I'll select the eyebrow, go to weight paint mode, and sampling the region around the brows revealed the transferred bone heat from the figure. One thing I like doing after using the transfer option is to go through the vertex groups in the properties panel, and this is to remove redundant vertex group because not all transferred groups are useful, as some might even disfigure the object. So now I'm going to lock those I feel are important for the brows and then remove the redundant groups. So that is that for the eyebrows. Next item we're going to parent is the glasses. So now I'll select prop to rig button and then go with the bone parenting type, and of course we are parented to the head bone, and then I'll click OK. Now when I select the rig and then go to pose mode and press R twice to rotate the head bone, we can see the eyeglasses also follows the head. I just realized we have the eyelashes to work on as well. But before we go ahead with the eyelashes, let's quickly look at the glasses so I can point out something. You can see the glasses don't have any vertex group here in the properties panel, and even when I go to weight paint mode, you'll see that we can't sample any vertex group, and this is because the glasses were parented using the bone option, which does not add any vertex group to the object. So let's go ahead and work on the eyelashes now, which are hidden behind the glasses. So with that selected, I'm going to click the parent prop to rig button, and again I'll go with the transfer option and then click OK. So that's done. Now let's first hide the glasses for now by pressing H. I'll select the eyelashes and then go to weight paint mode. Now sampling the eyelashes, we can see all these weight groups, although I don't need some of these weight groups affecting the eyelashes. So now I'll quickly try to remove every vertex group that has nothing to do with the eyelashes. Let me quickly close the eyes so we can see how the eyelashes deform with the eyes. So now I'll go back to object mode and select the rig, then go to the items panel up here and then turn on the primary layer in the rig layer panel to see some of the face control bones. Now I'll go to pose mode and then move these upper eyelid bone to close the eyes. Let me turn on x-axis mirror here so that it mirrors on the other eye. I will close the eyes. You can see the eyes close, but the eyelashes are not entirely coming along. So now I'm going to leave the eyes closed, then go back to object mode and select the eyelashes, and then go to waist paint mode. And this way I can see how removing some of the vertex group affect the eyelashes in real time. Okay, so after removing some of the groups, you can see we have a weird deformation of the eyelashes. And now to fix this, all we need to do is go up here to width, then select the smooth option. And then down here, I'll expand these command properties in the viewport and change the subset to all groups. Maybe I'll also increase the iteration a little. I think I'm satisfied with the result. Now I'll go to object mode, select the rig, then go to pose mode, and then reset the rig here in the Rig-GNS panel. Now when I select the upper eyelid bone and move it, you can see that the eyelashes move with the eyelids. So that is that for the eyelashes. Now let's press Alt H to unhide the glasses. Okay, so I'm going to pause the video here. I do not want it to be too long. There's a part 2 for this if you are interested in how I parent the rest of the items. Okay, so that is that. I hope you enjoyed the video. If not, you can give me another chance by trying out the other video or any of the suggested video on your screen. So thank you for your time. I'll see you in the next one.